Dear brothers and sisters, first of all, Chronia Pola to all Spiridons who are celebrating their name day today, many years and good strength for the rest of the year and the rest of your lives. Then I would like to share a few words about today's prophetic gospel. Our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ speaks about almost the entire history of Christianity. In this gospel, our Lord and Savior identifies the people of God and the way, the door from this world to the heavenly sanctuaries, the place where humanity belongs. He identifies the Good Shepherd. He identifies the doorkeeper. He also identifies the false prophets, the hired servants, the ones that come in the name of Christ but come for stealing because they are thieves. He identifies the wolves that will be outside and inside of the fold, and he warns us to be careful. Many times we have mentioned that the kingdom of God is present here in the church. So in a sense, Christ is talking about every single community, and the entire Christianity, the entire community of Christians in the world at once. He speaks about the fold, about which he warns us that the only door is himself, and no one can come in and out of that door except the ones who recognize him, and that the sheep recognize his voice and they will not follow the hirelings, and that there is one fold and one shepherd. The door of the sheepfold is Christ. And then he mentions about a doorkeeper, and then he talks about wolves. In this world full of dangers, we are to be careful what doors we enter through. We have to recognize the doorkeepers, make sure that the doorkeeper opens the door only to the shepherd, not to other hirelings, and most importantly, which I want to concentrate a little longer, is we are to be aware of the wolves. It says in the gospel that another danger is the hired servant or hired shepherd that comes and herds the sheep for a while until the wolves attack and the hired shepherd leaves, runs away, and the wolves devour the sheep. But the good shepherd lays down his life for his sheep. He talks about himself who has laid down his life for all of humanity. And he talks about those who have come before him or after him who are there to collect the benefits from the sheep and leave them in the fangs of the wolves when the danger arises. In today's world, dear brothers and sisters, there are dangers for the Christians that has never been before in Christian history. There are all kinds of traps, all kinds of confusions, misleading, misguiding opportunities, so-called for us, that lead us astray from the fold, and then we become victims for the wolves that are waiting for us behind every bush. As a young boy, I have had the privilege of being a shepherd, and I have heard hundreds of sheep at once, and it is a very amazing work. It requires an art. It requires vigilance. It requires even, I have to say, relationship with the sheep. I have learned from many, many examples throughout those young years, how do the wolves devour the sheep? One of the ways that they do is they fool the dogs that are guarding the sheep, and then another wolf arrives in front of the herd, and the sheep, as sheepish they are, they start following them until they get to the other side of the hill, invisible from the eyes of the dogs and the shepherd, and then all the wolves attack and destroy every single one of them. One phenomenon is very interesting, that when the wolves attack the sheep, they do not get satisfied from one sheep. They do not get satisfied after they kill 5, 10, according to the number of the pack of the wolves. When the wolves attack the sheepfold, they destroy the whole entire fold. They kill every single one of the sheep. They eat one, and they leave the rest dead. So in a sense, it's an instinct of killing, not a necessity of feeding themselves. The vigilant shepherd knows the signs when the wolves are near. The dogs start barking. The sheep become restless because they can sense the wolves. And the shepherd guards day and night to protect the fold from the attack of the merciless wolves. Dear brothers and sisters, when the wolves come from outside of the fold, it is very practical to do all the things that I mentioned to protect the fold, to protect the sheep. But our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ does not warn his disciples about the wolves that come from the outside. He warns about the wolves in the skin of sheep, the wolves that come in disguise. I mentioned how awful the wolves can be to the sheep when they attack them in the woods. But our Lord and Savior does not talk about that level of cruelty and sneakiness that in the nature, the natural wolves, the animal wolves can practice. He talks about higher level of wolfishness, higher level of animosity, higher level of anger, higher level of revenge, higher level of destruction of the sheepfold. And thus, he speaks about wolves in the skins of sheep. Not the dogs, not the sheep, not even the shepherd sometimes can identify those devouring wolves that cover themselves with sheepskins. They are the most dangerous kind. These are the kind that pretend to be sheep, and when the shepherd turns his face away from them, they devour, kill one sheep at a time. They do not destroy the entire flock. Otherwise, they would be identified. But the sheep are killed one at a time, and the wolves in the skins of sheep remain within the fold. And the shepherd keeps finding that sheep in the corners of the fold. When speaking about the Pharisees that come to him, our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ calls them hypocrites. The word hypocritis in Greek means the one who acts, the one who pretends to be someone else. This word was usually used in the Roman theater for the actors and actresses. And the custom was that the actors and actresses covered their faces with a mask So in order to understand clearly what our Lord and Savior speaks about when he talks about wolves in the skins of sheep, we can use this example of looking at people and calling them hypocrites who are something else inside and are presenting themselves to be something else entirely. Like the actors and actresses put the mask of that character they were playing on the stage, and when the act was over, they would come off the stage and take the mask and be their true self. They may be playing a saint, they may be playing a goddess or god, they may be playing a hero, but they were never any of those things that they played. They had their miserable life in the Roman culture and society. After the theater was over, they plunged themselves into the world and they did what they pleased. Although minutes before that, they were playing this exalted hero of the Roman Empire, or presenting a god or a goddess who does good things for humanity. Our Lord and Savior calls us to have one mind. Be innocent like doves, he says. Innocence does not mean naiveness. To become victims of the wolves of any kind, the ones that come from the outside, that the ones are inside. Innocent means to have a pure heart and single mind. Do not waver your mind this way or the other. Keep your eyes on Christ and walk diligently. Be afraid of nothing but God alone, and walk straight and only to one shepherd and to the call of one shepherd, that is our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, who is leading and guiding his church through his Holy Spirit, now and forever, and to the ages of ages. Amen. May the Lord bless you and strengthen you.